Bonjour. Today's video is on a topic that is not there in the book, but it is something that is very important. And since we have some few days left before the end of the session, I will teach you how to solve a system of equations of the first degree. In French, système d'équation du premier degré. So let's start with a little bit of recap. If I write 1 plus 4 is equal to 2 plus 3, this is known as an equality, or in French, une égalité. And what it means is that the membre gauche is equal to the membre droit. And if you remember, we had any equality, if you add the same quantity to both sides, it remains an equality. If you subtract from both sides, it remains an equality. If you multiply both sides by the same number, non-zero number, it remains an equality. If you divide both sides by the same non-zero number, it remains an equality. What is an equation? An equation is an equality with an unknown. So this is an example of an equation. 3x plus 4 is equal to 16. Equation avec un ou plusieurs inconnus. So that is, it is an equation, sorry, it's an equality with one or more unknowns. In this case, the unknown is x. There will be only one value of x that will satisfy this equality. And that one value of x is called the solution of the equation. So let's take another equation, une autre équation. 3x plus 4y est égal à 20. This is also an equation, but this is two unknowns. So, of course, here there will be several combinations of values which will make this equality true. If x is equal to 1, then y will have to have some value, and you will get a combination of values which will give you 20. Une équation est une égalité avec un ou plusieurs inconnus. L'égalité est vraie pour seulement quelques valeurs des inconnus. And these valeurs are known as the solution. So, of course, here there can only be one value. Here there can be an infinite combination of values which will give you 20. Here 3x plus 4y is equal to 20. Okay. So let's say if x plus y is equal to 10, rather than take that example which I can't think of the answers in my head, here I can. If I have x plus y is equal to 10, then you can say, quel valeur en ce cas, x est égal à 1, y est égal à 9. Or, x est égal à moins 1, y est égal à 11. Ou x est égal à 2, y est égal à 8. Ou x est égal à 1,5 et y est égal à 8,5. So, these are the solution to this equation which turn it into an equality. Okay. So, équation du premier degré avec un inconnu. So, premier degré, I explained this to you in the last video. It's right here, I think. This is a premier degré equation which has only x. This is a deuxième degré equation which has x carré. That's all it means. If in the equation you have an unknown which is to the carré, then it's a second degree equation. If it is to the cube, then it is a third degree equation. So, something that has nothing, no power, that is power of 1, this is 2 into x to the power 1 actually. We never write it. But this means this is une équation du premier degré avec un inconnu, because there's only one unknown x here. If you try to solve it, you will get 2x est égal à moins 6 moins 3. When you take 3 on the other side, the sign changes. Basically, you're subtracting 3 from both sides. You'll get 2x est égal à moins 9. Donc, x est égal à moins 9 sur 2. Donc, x est égal à 4,5. And this is the solution to this equation. If you put this value back in there, and you do membre gauche and membre droite, you will see that they are equal. Okay, this is the a reminder of what an equation is and a reminder of what a solution to an equation is. So, to this I will not prove. To get a unique solution, here you had an infinite number of solutions when we did this, x plus y is equal to 10, you have an infinite number of solutions. But if you want a unique solution to a first degree equation, then you have to have n equation avec n inconnu. So the same number of equations as the number of unknowns. So if you have x and y as unknowns, then you have to have two equations. So let's take those inconnu. So we have the 3x plus y4 est égal à 78, x plus y est égal à 12. So these are two separate equations, but together they make a system d'équation, they make a system of equations, and there are only unique values of x and y, that means there's only one x value and one y value which will satisfy both these equations. What do you mean by satisfy? Which when plugged in will make these two equalities true or correct. Okay. Pour pouvoir résoudre un système d'équations, il faut que les équations satisfont à deux conditions. So, to be able to find out x and y, that means to be able to solve these equations, we have to ensure that two conditions are satisfied. And in most equations we get, those two conditions are always satisfied. When I say, when we get, which the books give us as problems. The first condition is les équations doivent être indépendantes. What does this mean? That means on ne peut pas arriver à une des équations à partir des autres. So let's take an example with two equations. X plus y est égal à 10. That's the first equation. 2x plus 2y est égal à 20. So these two equations are not independent. Why? Because if you multiply the top equation by 2, 2x plus 2y is equal to 20, then you get the second equation. So these two equations are essentially the same, because if you take this lower equation and you divide it both sides by 2, you will get x plus y is equal to 10, which is the same as the first one. So essentially, these two equations are not independent, and therefore, these two equations cannot be solved to get values of x and y, because basically any value where x plus y is equal to 10 will also satisfy this. So if x is 1 and y is 9, if you put it here you will get 20. X is 1, y is 9, this will be 2 plus 18 is equal to 20. If you take x is 2 and y is 8, you will get 10, but again if you take x is 2 and y is 8, you will get 20. So there is no unique solution. So these two equations are not independent. I have another example here of three equations with three unknowns. X plus y plus z. The z is the third unknown here. So if I do x plus y plus z is equal to 12. 2x plus 3y plus 5z is equal to 78. 3x plus 4y plus 6z is equal to 90. So these two, three equations are also not independent. Now how do I know that? Because I wrote them. See, if you look closely, you will see that this third equation is the sum of the top two equations. So x plus 2x est égal à 3x, y plus 3y est égal à 4y, z plus 5z est égal à 6z, 12 plus 78 est égal à 90. So you can say cette équation est la somme des deux autres. So that means this is a derived equation. It has come from those two, and again these equations ne sont pas indépendantes. So that is the first condition. The equations have to be independent. You shouldn't be able to get one from the others. Here I say from the others because there are two others. Here from the other because there's only one of them. Ok, deuxième condition, les équations doivent être consistantes. They have to be consistent. C'est-à-dire, pas contradictoires. So, I'll give you two equations. X plus Y est égal à 10. 3x plus 3y equal to y. So obviously these are not consistent, because if x plus y is equal to 10, then 3x plus 3y should equal 30. Correct? We are multiplying both sides by 3. 3x plus 3y should equal 30. But the second equation we have been given is 3x plus 3y is equal to 40. So if you try to solve this, you will see that you will be unable to find values of x and y which satisfy both equations. You can try, whatever you try, you will not get values of x plus y which satisfy two different, both these equations. So because if you divide the lower one by 3, you will get x plus y is equal to 10 there. Here you will get x plus y is equal to 40 divided by 3, that is 13.3. So how can x plus y equal 10 as well as x plus y equal 13.3? So therefore these two equations are not consistent and they are actually contradictoire, that is they are contradictory. Okay, so these two conditions have to be satisfied. I am telling you this for the sake of completeness. In all the problems I will give you in the next few days, you will see that these conditions will be satisfied. You will not have to check them. Okay, so now we come to how do we solve these equations. So there are three methods, and remember from the last video when I explained that I will be teaching you this, one of the reasons I am teaching you this is because it is a nice way of showing how mathematics should be done and how mathematics can be done. I'll explain this statement as we go along. Okay, so there are trois méthodes de résolution. They have got names. One is elimination, one is comparaison, one is substitution. Elimination, comparaison, substitution. I will take a system of two equations and I will solve the same problem in all three manner, all three ways, all three methods, and you will see that I will get the same result. I will, at the end of that, I will suggest which one of these you should always use and which ones, the other two you should really not use because of the reasons I will tell you as we go along. So elimination, this is the, these are our two equations, and I will first solve it using the method de elimination. So 3x plus 7y égale à 20. 4x plus 3y est égal à 40. Ce sont mes deux équations. Je les numérote ici, 1 et 2. Équation numéro 1, équation numéro 2. So I'm using this method of numbering the equations. So then I can say, I can refer back to say, look at equation number 1 or look at equation number 2. So how does elimination work? So elimination requires you to think a little bit. So what it does is, for example, on multiply equation 1 par 4, when I say on multiply equation 1 par 4, I mean you multiply both sides by 4, so the égalité is preserved. And the second equation, on multiply equation 2 par moins 3. And why have I chosen 4 and 3 here? Because this is 4, so I am multiplying that by 4. And this is 3, so I am multiplying the lower one by minus 3. One of them I change the sign. Why am I doing this? It will become clear in the next few seconds. So if I multiply the top equation by 4, then what do I get? I get 12x plus 28y, correct? 7 into 4 is 28, is equal to 80. 4 into 20 is equal to 80. This I will call my equation 3. Always write in brackets so that you don't get confused that you are actually referring to an equation number. The number 2 equation I multiply by minus 3, I will get minus 12x minus 9y minus 120. 40 into minus 3 gives me 120. So this is one equation, this is another equation. Both of these, equation 1 is the same as equation 3, equation 2 is the same as equation 4. But what do you see here? You see here it is 12 and minus 12x, and here it is 20. So by multiplying by 4, I got 12x here. By multiplying this by minus 3, I got minus 12x. So essentially, the next step in this process of elimination is to add these two equations. You add the left sides together and you add the right sides together to get one equation. So two equations, you're adding the same term on. So let's take the first equation. To the first equation, in the equation number 3, you're adding equation number 4. So the left term of the equation number 4, you're adding to the left term of equation number 3. And similarly with the right side, the right term mom rudrat of equation number 4, you're adding to the mom rudrat of equation number 3. So when you add it up, ajuta trua ekat on raswa duzix mwen duzix, sase on a 0x, plus 28 mwen 9, sase plus 21y, ici on a 80 mwen 120, sa nous donne mwen 80. So what do you see? 0x is the same as 0, so you get 21y is equal to minus 40. So in this method, what you have done is you have eliminated one unknown. You have eliminated x in this case. You could have also multiplied this one by 3 and this one by minus 7. Then you would have got 21y there and you would have got minus 21y, you multiply the entire thing by minus 7, here you multiply the entire thing by 3, and in which case this would have added up to 0 and you would have eliminated y. But we have done it this way and we have eliminated x, so we get 21y is equal to minus 40 on a éliminer un inconnu. Donc y est égal à There we go. I don't know why I wrote 19. 28 minus 9 is 19. So 19y is equal to minus 40. So y is equal to minus 40 over 19. Here I wrote it correctly. I don't know why I wrote 21 there. So this is our, we have already found the value of y. So we know the value of y is equal to minus 40 over 19. In these problems, you should always remember to keep the answer exact, that is in fractional form. Don't find out a decimal number because then you will get propagating round off errors when you put it back. So remplaça 5 en 1. So now I'm not using the word equation short form there. I'm just putting it brackets. Remplaça 5 en 1. So this value I'm putting back in equation number 1. I could also put it in equation number 2, but I've been doing it in 1. So the one first I copy it is 3x plus 7y is equal to 20. Y I already know is this. So I multiply it. 3x plus 7 into 40 minus 40 over 19 is equal to 20. So then if I do, it will become 3x plus minus 280, 7 into minus 40 is minus 280 over 19 is equal to 20, which gives us 57x minus 280 is equal to 380. How is that? Because I multiply everything by 19, I get 19 into 3, 57x, 19 multiply into all of this, the 19 will cancel out, 19 into 20 is 380. So when I take minus 280 to that side, I'll get 660, 280 plus 380, 660, and x is equal to, and then I divide both sides by 57, I'll get x is equal to 660 divided by 57. So essentially, we have solved these equations, this system of equations, and if you put in this value, and this value, if you plug it into both these equations, I'm not going to do it now, but if you do it, Mamre-Ghosh, you will get 20 here, and if you do Mamre-Ghosh here, you will get 40. So you can verify that these two values are indeed the solutions to this system of equation. So this is the way to do it with elimination. Why isn't it such a good method? Is because you have to think. Thinking is always prone to errors. You have to think, I will try to eliminate x, So the top one I'll multiply by 4 and the bottom one I'll multiply by minus 3. Or if you try to eliminate y, you would say, the top I'll multiply by 3 and the bottom I'll multiply by 7. No, not 7, minus 7. So you'll get minus 21y here, plus 21y here, and when you would add that up, these would get zeroed out, so you would eliminate y. In this particular instant, we eliminated x. On I eliminate on iconu, which is the x, because when you add minus 12x, you get 0x. Okay, so this is known as elimination. And now we will go to the method of comparison, which is also a nice method, but I don't like it, because the problem with these three methods is elimination and comparison are best used for system of two equations with two unknowns. Substitution, which I like and which I would recommend that you use all the time, is a method that can be used with any number of unknowns any number of unknowns with that many number of equations. One of my batches, I even gave them 6 equations with 6 unknowns. It was a huge work, and quite a few of them got it right. But they couldn't have used elimination or comparison in that case. They had to use substitution in French. So let's do this by comparison. So here the technique is slightly different. What they do is they find out x as a function of y from the first equation and x as a function of y in the second equation. So what does it mean? It means put x on the left, and what does it equal to? So par 1 means I'm taking equation 1. I write 3x plus 7y is equal to 20. So x is equal to 20 minus 7y divided by 3. Now you know enough of your maths to be able to do this quickly. 20 minus 7y divided by 3 will give you x. You move 7y that side, you'll get 20 minus 7y. You'll only have 3x this side. You divide both sides by 3, you'll get x on the left. X is equal to 20 minus 7y divided by 3. Let's call this our equation 3. Again, if you find that I'm going too fast, either slow down the playback and on YouTube or rewind and rewatch them. Okay, so then we take equation 2 and we do the same thing. We find out what x is as a function of y from equation 2. Why do I say as a function of y? Yes, because x is here and this is a function. F of x is this. But think of it as that you're just putting x on the left and everything else on the right. So from here I get 4x plus 3y is equal to 40. So here you get x is equal to 40 minus 3y over 4. 40 minus 3y, because you're taking 3y that side, divided by 4 will give you this. So your equation 3 tells you that 20 minus 7y over 3 is equal to x. Your equation 4 tells you 40 minus 3y over 4 is equal to x. So what does it mean? It means 40 minus 3y over 4 is equal to 20 minus 7y over 3. Because both of them are equal to the same thing, so that means this term is equal to this term. So, par 3 eka, trompe ekri, dvam moe set y sur 3, tegara karant moe 3 y sur 4. Karant moe 3 y sur 4, dvam moe set y sur 3. So, I have now an equation, but again you see, we only have one unknown. So, in this case, we didn't multiply equations to get rid of the unknown. We just took x on the left and x on the left, and then we equated whatever was left on the right sides in both cases, both equations. So now we have this, and now this is an equation with one unknown. We can solve it. We multiply both sides by, we can do a cross multiplication, which is a term I don't really like, but it is a short form for saying I multiply everything by 4 and everything by 3. So I get 4 into 20 minus 4 into 7y, that is 80 minus 28y is equal to 3 into 40, 120, minus 3y into 3, which is minus 9y. So if you solve this, you'll get minus 19y. When you take plus 9y on that side, you'll get minus 19y. When you take 80 on this side, you'll get 40. You'll get y is equal to minus 40 over 19. This is the same thing we got earlier. Y is equal to 40 over 19 in elimination. Now that you have y, and you know x is equal to this, and x is equal to this, so value of y you can put here or here to get x. Both of those will give you the same and correct answer. So we say remplaçant 5 en 3, I take 3. So the first thing is I copy down 3. X est égal à 20 moins 7 y sur 3. See, I'm copying it down, I'm not replacing straight away. Be systematic. So is equal to 20 minus 7 into y. Y is minus 40 over 19, so into minus 40 over 19 divided by 3. So if I take common multiples there, 19 into 20 gives me 380. Minus 7 into minus 40 will give me plus 280 divided by 19 divided by 3. Remember, the equal sign is here, not there. And when you do this, then if you remember how to divide fractions, then 19 will come down. You will get 380 plus 280 divided by 3 into 19, which will give you 660 over 57, which is what you had. 660 over 57 from the elimination. Okay, so now we are 27 minutes into the video, and now comes substitution. So I will leave that for the second video that I will do for tomorrow. So I stop here, and there is no in-video problem. Watch this video, and remember, I haven't taught you substitution yet. The next video we will do substitution. We will start with this same equation, and we will solve it, and then I will also show you how to solve three equations with three unknowns using substitution. Okay, I stop here.